Who's your best friend at school?
Noah.
Is it a boy?
Good morning. Here I am with my glucose drink.
Guys, Cara just got back from Target and we got the goods. One, we got her milk, my milk, so I can show you guys my cool thing.
Oh, look at these goodies. Okay. Yeah.
No!
Put
one doll in each bag. Start back here.
So.
Or start right there. Okay.
Cara, what is she doing?
She's filling up her bags that she's gonna take to school with her.
Oh. This is like the best time. You guys remember when we went to school and it was your birthday, so you brought the treats?
No, you already did that one. No. That one.
It should be the other way around, but it was so fun.
Do this one.
You brought the treats, and now these are for all classmates.
Normally, we do like baked goods, but with COVID, they need to have like totally
wrapped,
pre-packaged things,
yeah,
not
makes
like
sense. We were gonna do
it. Like last year, we did like cupcakes, but
yeah, we were gonna do delicious cookies, but it's okay. Oh, we just got a couple of these. We're stoked for these. Ashley and Chad have these and they are so amazing. They fit in your cup holder in your car.
The balls are done. Sit down.
All right, Gemma. Oh, I see my Crispix.
She got these.
And my honey roasted. Yes.
Mermaid bracelet.
You got mermaid bracelets, Gemma?
I want to try them on.
Wow.
I want to try the pink one. She looks fancy on me. And I like her shell. Super like it.
But we only have enough to go in each bag, so you gotta put it in the bag. But you get to keep one of these bags too.
Fancy Nancy.
Whoa.
Jenna. Whoa.
Okay, John, put it in the bags.
Oh, each color.
Fancy Nancy.
Each color.
Your classmates
of the
are
rainbow.
Gonna love these, yes. Gemma.
Okay, wait, do this one. No.
Oh,
this
she's
one?
So excited to go give them to her classmates.
I know. And yeah. Mom, which one's going to be for me?
Whichever one you want.
You can choose whatever one,
I
darling.
Think I want.
And then we have candy canes to put
what?
In each one.
Candy canes! What?
And then we have fun dip.
That is so fun. Your classmates are gonna love
for
it.
Me, yes,
for like Valentine's Day, I did like all organic candy, and then this time I'm just like.
Gemma, they're going to wish that it was your birthday every day.
Yes.
Can't I help you?
The jelly belly candy canes. Those are the best.
Get the good flavor.
Good job.
Watermelon.
Good job.
Okay, you guys already know I've been super stoked and waiting anxiously for Cara to get home so I can try my crunch cup, my cereal to go cup. So let's whip it out.
Okay, guys, I just washed it, so it's all clean. This is my milk spot. This is my cereal that goes in there. And the instructions, they're hilarious. Look at the very bottom. It says, do not microwave or evil spirits will emerge. That's amazing. Okay, let's try it.
Okay, get my delicious almond milk. All right, ladies and gentlemen, where's my fill line? Wait, I don't see a fill line.
It filled the marshmallow.
Maybe that's it, I don't know.
Now, which one do you want in your bag?
Okay, got that done. Let's pour some cereal in. Ready? Crispix in it. We'll do Crispix. Boom.
One.
Let's go.
Two.
Okay. Oh, I probably should have poured my cereal first. Oops.
Cherry.
I should have put my cereal in first. I can just do it by hand. I'm spilling so much. Oh man, I'm not good at this. I'm used to those bowls, you know? Those bowls. Ah, okay.
I need you to take this camera real quick. Kara thinks this looks disgusting.
It is so weird.
I think it looks amazing.
That's disgusting.
It's not. Okay, here. Oh, wait. I want to see.
Good job.
Gemma. She's signing her
Let's
name.
Make it a little bit darker.
Good job, Gemma.
Okay, so I've already held it for like 5 minutes and it's not soggy. See, that's already genius. Wow, that's I'm already loving it. Brilliant. Except it really depends on how this experience is right here.
How much milk comes with how much cereal? It just can't be right.
Mom?
He's gonna act like it's right, even if it's not. Mom, just to like prove mommy, himself.
No, I'm not. Perfect what? Amount of milk. Come out. Look at the hole. Look at that. It's tiny. Try it again.
Okay, you have this.
It looks really gross. Like if I saw someone eating that, I would be like,
no, you'd be like what are you doing? I'd be like, have you seen the crunch cup? It works. Actually, works good. No leaking. It's separated. It goes in your mouth. One more time.
The way you shake the milk looks really gross. Like you're like shaking milk into your mouth.
I'm a fan. I just wish it was like 5 times bigger because I eat way more cereal than that.
Oh my gosh. On to Gemma. What are you doing?
I'm trying to make a G.
Well, we can't make a G on that. That one's for someone in your class.
Oh.
But you made a G on yours. And then she checked all the bags to make sure they had everything, right?
They have everything, and I'm including this one. Okay, so shine.
Beautiful. You excited for school tomorrow?
Yeah.
Now you've got to pick out what you're going to wear.
Super.
Yay. What are you going to wear?
Dress. I get this dress away.
A Christmas dress?
Yeah.
Fancy.
Okay, I just finished my first crunch cup. I'm just gonna say, this is a dumb Instagram purchase. It was the perfect ratio of cereal to milk. 100% has my stamp of approval. I'll throw it in the description if you guys wanna go buy it. It's like 30 bucks. And I'm gonna take this with me a lot in the car. I'm gonna eat cereal in the car. I'm gonna probably order another one because that wasn't a lot of cereal. But for like Kara and Gemma, it's probably perfect. And Carrie just said, I'll never use that. Okay. Sorry, babe.
Gemma.
What?
We just taught Gemma how to do her first fun stick, and she's having fun. She might have opened one more sucker than she was supposed to. We're going to save it for tomorrow, okay? That was your first fun dip. Do you like it?
No, I still
Did you like it?
It? Yeah, but I'm still having it.
Okay. Did Mom teach you how to do it? Can you show me how to do it?
I have to do the stick.
Okay, get the stick, and then what?
And then put it on sugar.
I remember.
Then we had to eat it.
Oh my gosh, that's amazing. Back in my day, Cara, or sorry, Gemma, I suck with names. Back in my day, those are the coolest things ever. We love those. So fun they're still around.
Those and pixie sticks. Do you guys remember pixie sticks? Like the most delicious, annoying treat because once that you got it wet, it didn't come out anymore. Once you got that paper wet, so then you had to like throw it away. I love those. And they were super messy. Just like those, Gemma. It's like a parent's worst nightmare, huh? Because they're delicious for kids and they're super messy.
Look at that, Gemma. All that candy and the gold crown. And then Mom tied it with a nice little bow, and then Gemma did her little signature on it. Oh, not this one. Those are so awesome. Are you excited to give those to your classmates? Such a fun girl. You need a good mom.
And my teacher said, Gemma, and I'll come up and get all my gifts to everyone, but how can I carry them all?
We'll have to put them in like a big cardboard box or something.
Yeah, we'll help you carry them, okay?
And how I'll can say, I carry this them is for everyone.
Mm-hmm. Oh, and they're gonna be like, Gemma, we wanna hug you. And then are you gonna hug all of them at the same time?
I could go by one and one and one and one.
Okay.
And then, and open our gifts. When we get home.
Who's your best friend at school?
Noah.
Noah? Is it a boy?
No,
it's
a girl.
Oh, okay. My heart.
Good morning. Here I am with my glucose drink. So we're going to my appointment in 1 hour. Have to chug this baby. Gemma, come here. Gemma's is all ready for her school today because it's her birthday day at school. So she chose to wear her wedding dress. Huh? Let me see, do a spin. You look so beautiful. I feel like people make this drink out to be like so disgusting. I mean, it's not good. It's always better than I'm anticipating because people make it out to be so gross. Definitely not good, especially fruit punch is like my least favorite flavor. It's doable. I'm almost done, and then I have to mark my time down of when I finished so I can get my blood drawn in exactly 1 hour. Can't wait.
Okay, guys, the triplets are owning this table. We didn't think they would last that long over their high chairs, but I don't know if they're gonna go back to their high chairs because they absolutely love this thing.
Hi, buddy. Look. Roland, look. The table's so fun, huh? Look at it. They just sit here and they just take their bites and they even feed each other. Ren, I saw you feeding Reese just barely. Want to give another bite? Reese, she wants a bite. You guys, that's so cute. And I fed the cats and, oh, see that black one that ran away? There's a new, smaller black cat. We have no idea where.
it came from. But it comes and tries to eat the food a little bit. But it's very skittish. Like, we try to pet it and it runs away.
And it's kind of unfortunate because it's like a mini Ava. It's like a really small black cat, so it's super cute. It's coming. I don't think it's coming. No, it's Ava. But we want to pet it and it never lets us. It's so unfortunate. It's like once cats get to a certain age and they have never been around humans, like, I feel like they're scarred for life and they're never going to be good around people. Like, they run off the second we open the door. They skedaddle.
That's Ava, huh? Ava's fluffy. Hi, fluffy Ava.
Let's wait for the black cat to come back. I know it's lurking somewhere.
Oh, Mama Kitty's back. Hi, Mama Kitty. Hi, Mama Kitty. Have some food. Here. Here you go, Mama Kitty. I'll give one for you. There you go, Mama Kitty. Here, Pumpkin, go back over here. Yeah, no, Pumpkin, go back over here. Pumpkin, over here some more. Did they already finish it? Wow, you guys are freaking hungry. That's three cans. Feed the Mama Kitty. They just go around saying Mama. Oh, so soft. Be soft, friend. Oh, it's so cute, huh? Oh. Good job, Mama Kitty. Oh, I got a glimpse of it. Come back, the black cat. Got a glimpse of it, the freaking runner. Gemma, who is that?
Mama.
Oh, Mom, look. She has your eyes and your big mouth. That's a beautiful mom. Mom, it looks just like you.
Yeah, it does. Now who are you drawing?
Yeah, who's that, Gemma?
Dad. With a big head.
With a big head? Gemma, it's not that big.
It's kind of big, huh?
I have a big bowl because whenever I wore hats, I always have to do it to the biggest size. Whenever it's a snapback, I go to like the last one or the second to last one. And some of my friends have it so small that it doesn't even fit over the rim. Yeah, big head. Cara, how was your, so Cara, she threw up a few times today. How was your drink today? Made you feel kind of nauseous?
Mm-hmm. Sickening. Literally sickening.
Or I can dump them out over here. Yeah.
Yes. Good job. Gemma's gonna call. Okay, Gemma, you have to be a little quiet, okay? After you dump all those out.
That bag is just loud. Good job.
Let me see the bag. Okay, Cara, no yawning. So, Cara took a drink. What does it taste like?
So people always say that it tastes like so, so, so disgusting, but that it makes it not taste as bad because you're expecting it to be like way worse than it is, you know? Like you're expecting
it's
it to like make you...
It's going to be mommy again.
Oh, that's okay. Nice. It's going to be mommy. I was this close to drinking it, by the way, because like in there,
yeah, it looks... Yeah, he found it in the fridge.
It looks like some just delicious fruit punch.
Like a little Gatorade. I had the fruit punch, and fruit punch is like my least favorite flavor. Cherry is my least favorite, and then fruit punch.
Cara hates everything cherry. It's so weird to me because she hates...
I like real cherries.
She hates cherry licorice, like cherry candy, cherry Skittles. Anything cherry, she sets it aside.
It tastes like cough medicine.
Well, a lot of cough medicine does taste like cherries.
It's like cherry flavored. Yeah. So it just like...
I hear ya. But some things are delicious, like cherry limeades. Yum.
I can kind of handle a limeade, but I'd rather have a different flavor.
More because it's like limeade instead of cherry. Uh-huh. So yeah, I was this close to drinking it.
Yeah, he got it out and was like about drinking. He's like, wait, what is this? I'm like, a glucose. That's cute.
That is cute.
He's like, a glucose test drink?
So I call it the pregnancy drink. So anyway, we get results when?
They said by Monday.
Are you feeling anything weird? Like, do you feel like they're gonna be fine? Good results?
I haven't had it before, so I'm not like expecting to have it.
I'm sorry, my hands are getting covered in crayons.
You're getting covered in crayons?
Or markers.
It's okay, Gemma. We can wash them off.
So, I mean, I'm not like expecting to have it. I think it'll be fine.
We're hoping and praying that everything's good. So far, everything has been great. Another question that a lot of people have, I've seen in comments before, and I'm the one that actually saved. I screenshotted the comment because I was like, oh yeah, Cara can probably answer that. But they said with this pregnancy, so baby number 5, what has been like the hardest thing? Because Kara's been through pregnancy now 3 times, but they want to know now what has been the hardest with baby number 5, like at this point. So for this pregnancy, and we haven't even talked about this, so I don't even know. So I'm just going to roll with what you say, but for you as the mother, what has been the hardest part of this pregnancy?
The hardest thing, like physically, with every pregnancy, I've had something called PGP. It's pelvic girdle pain, it's called like S. I looked up what the other term
All I know is that this girl...
SPD, it's symphysis pubis dysfunction, but it's basically where like your pelvic joints move like unevenly. I think it's caused from like the hormone that like relaxes your whole body, like relaxes like all like the ligaments and everything. So my pelvis, if you stand on like 1 foot and it gets uneven, it's like excruciating pain, like so bad. And not very many, I think it's like, I wanna say it's like 10% of pregnant people get it or something. Like, it's not like that common.
You could probably say 8%.
Maybe it's like 30%.
We could literally say 7%, 2%, or 46%. No one's going to.
But I mean, it's not like super, super common. Like, I mean, people get like aches and pains and like.
Guys, 24.7% of people get this, so.
I had it with Gemma, and then of course I had it with the triplets, like extra, because they're so heavy. But it just hurts really bad. Like, it's more when you're like kind of uneven, so like stairs, or getting like in and out of a car, or a chair, or a bed, or something, it just.
Bed.
Yeah, especially when I like have slept in bed, and sometimes it even pops. Like, makes a loud popping noise.
Can't be
when
healthy.
When I like roll over or like get out, it just.
I remember just in bed, Cara a lot of times like.
It hurts so bad to
tells
roll
me
over.
She can't roll over. She's like, I can't roll over. Because you have to use like your legs.
You have to like smooth like, your legs.
You're growing.
Like, you're moving that, and it's like, so, it hurts my pelvis so bad to like lift my legs over to the other side.
It's like, since you can't do that, she just sits there like, I can't move. But yeah, I actually, that is one thing that I've realized with, she always is saying that her pelvic bones are hurting, and I just like think of it like she's just kind of like a petite in general, so it's like her hips are just like making way for the baby C to come out.
There have been a couple times, it's usually like if I could lay around all day with my feet up, it wouldn't be so bad. That's really cute. She raised her hand and made a turkey.
Wait, Cara, wait, Gemma, let me see the turkey. We'll show you guys. Gemma, show me the turkey on the other page. Okay, she's doing it again. I'll show you guys.
If it's when I'm on my feet a lot though during the day, or if I'm carrying one of the babies, the extra weight makes it hurt more. But when I'm on my feet a lot, it like by the end of the night, I'm like in so much pain. That's really good.
Good job, Gemma. Never done this. Are you doing an eye to put the eyes in the mouth? Here, guys, I'm gonna. We'll switch over to the iPhone. Ready? Okay, Gemma, show me your turkey.
I'm not ready yet.
Oh, it's not ready yet. Hold on. Okay, hold it up for me. Here you go, chat fam. Here's Gemma's turkey. Okay. So.
She learned how to make those at school.
Whoa, Gemma, that's a really good turkey.
Wait, let me see that. The first one you made too.
Yeah, show us the first one real quick.
Oh, is that one better?
Oh, you don't want to show us the first?
The first one was your practice room.
Oh, that's a cute one. Too. Let's see it, buddy. Oh, that one is adorable, Gemma. Good job.
This is for daddy and this is for mommy. Your daddy, mom, and dad, can you pass this to mom?
Yes, absolutely. There you go. Now that is adorable. I'm gonna frame that and keep it forever.
They're so cute. Turkeys.
Remember that you do it during this vlog.
So, that's my hardest part. Like, physically, it sucks. And the more I'm on my feet during the day, which is usually a lot because I can't just, like, go sleep all day, then the more it hurts at night.
Ooh, chocolate orange.
But, and not being able to rest. Like, when I was pregnant with Gemma, I took, like, 2 naps a day. It was so nice. I'd wake up, go to bar class, come home, take a nap, go eat lunch, take a nap, eat dinner, go to bed.
So like being pregnant with your first child, we were talking about this in the car today.
I did work too.
It's like the honeymoon stage of pregnancy because it's your first baby. So everything is like first time buying a crib, first time buying a stroller. Everything's so fun. Not saying that it's not fun when you have your other pregnancies, but.
I still enjoy picking everything out.
Yeah, but for the first time, it's like so fun. But I thought you were going to say the hardest part is being pregnant while having four.
Yeah, I think that contributes to. This pain, being so tired, like, is having the other four. Because I can't lay around and have my feet up all day.
It's just, you can't go nap.
I don't get to nap. I do get to nap sometimes, like, if it works out. But I rarely get to nap, because even when they are napping, that's when I can, like, get work done.
Yeah.
Like, I need a quiet house to, like,
that's actually
do
a really
film
cute
things
one.
And, like, get on the computer, do emails, that kind of stuff. I have to have it, like, I can't do it with the babies.
I'll get it.
When they are napping. I try to use that time to be productive, even though I want a nap. What is that one?
It's a turkey. That's a turkey?
It's so cute.
It's a cute one. So yeah, I'd say having four kids and her being pregnant has been like a lot different because they're all getting to the age where they're just nutsos.
Yeah, they're crazy.
They're so
like when
wild.
When I was pregnant with the triplets, Gemma was like their age. She was younger, a little bit younger. I only had her and I wasn't working. I didn't have like...
I don't remember.
So I really just had like Gemma to take care of and I could rest a lot when she was... resting.
Like, I'm thinking about when I say crazy, like it's in a good way. Like they're cute crazy. I remember on my Instagram story,
they
I
can
put,
be crazy crazy too.
Yeah, for sure. They are so good at like memorizing the songs and all the shows they watch. And in Frozen,
ooh.
It's a monster. In Frozen, cool. Whenever Olaf does his scream, the girls go wild.
all of them, and Royal does too. They're just so funny when they do that stuff. It's like, it's so crazy loud. And so you have that chaos going on all day, plus Cara drinking, you know, this stuff, drinking.
Plus Cara just drinking, just getting down in the
hammered. No, she's just drinking her pregnancy drink, and as we are taking care of them, and then feeling nauseous and throwing up, and I'm just like, oh my goodness, I feel like we need two more moms to move in full time. That would be very helpful.
Yeah, the triplets just go from cool to crazy really quick right now. It can all be smooth sailing, and then all of a sudden we're like, what just happened? Everyone is screaming.
And then usually when that happens, when they're bedtime, all going crazy, if it's not bedtime yet, we jump in the car.
Oh yeah, we'll go for a drive. We say, do you guys want to go for a ride? And they'll be like, ride, ride, ride. They get so excited and run to the door just to go for a ride.
They're literally like dogs wanting to go on a walk. We say, guys, let's go in the car. And they run to the door, jump in the van. We strap them in and we just go anywhere. So tonight we just drove and went up to my parents' house and just drove around the area. Just drove up the canyon, looked at the waterfall.
I don't know.
The leaves.
Dad, who got this?
I don't know who drew that, buddy. I'm so sorry. So yeah, I'd say for me, the hardest part of this pregnancy has been dealing with four wilds while still trying to make sure Cara has her needs and her stuff taken care of. But we're so grateful nonetheless for all of it. The fact that we are
bringing
another
person. I will say I'm a very
person.
Like low maintenance pregnant person.
Yeah, she's really good.
But
actually,
I did book up my first maternity massage.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, I have it on Monday.
Can I come?
I tried to get a couple's, but it was booked out like a week longer, so I just booked one for me.
Okay, that's fine.
I really did try to get a couple's one.
I'll just sit at home and eat chocolate oranges.
Oh, and you know what else we're doing?
Yeah, Mom, bring me some more oranges.
I also booked a 3D, 4D ultrasound.
Whoa, you did?
Yeah.
Gemma, hold on. I love making music too, but sometimes, thank you. Oh, speaking of music, I owe the Chat Fam a piano song soon. Because going back on our last vlogs, like our early vlogs, I played the piano so often. I haven't touched my piano in a long time. And that's something I don't want to forget. So I need to keep it up.
Yeah.
I'm gonna play you guys a song soon. What were you talking about before that? Oh, something about massage?
3D, 4D ultrasound.
Oh yeah. We love doing the 4D ultrasounds because all the detail.
Yeah, it's fun. Gemma in hers, she had this little like, she had like such a squishy face and she was like pretty squishy when she was born. And her lip had that like crease right here, you know?
Oh, yeah.
Like when it was squished, it like bent in half right in the middle, like that.
It's like a little butt cheek.
Like she always, when she's like passed out, she still gets that right there. So
that
it's so,
so
cute that it was like in her 3D, 4D ultrasound. Like you could see that line right
there.
We
need to find it.
Like her like lip like bends.
When we go to that appointment, we'll vlog it for you guys. And then we'll show baby C's pictures. And then we'll try to compare Gemma's.
And we have the triplets too.
And the triplets.
We got theirs,
yeah.
Like, every week.
We'll put them all side by side, but we can see.
Another password.
We can see who the baby resembles the most out of the four kids. But Cara, let's do some shout outs because you know what they say about vlogs that are too long, right?
No one wants to watch them.
I don't know what they're saying. There's actually some people on this channel that are so awesome and we love you guys that will watch every second and minute of every vlog, regardless of the length. Even when we threw out that vlog, it was 2.5 hours. Gemma, buddy. Okay, hold on. When we threw out that vlog, those 2.5 hours, they watched the whole thing. So thank you guys. Okay, so first shout out goes to Savannah Darsney. Savannah, thank you so much for being there for us in the comments section and for loving our family. We love you, Savannah. Thank you. Welcome to the Chat Fam. Welcome. We're glad to have you. All right, Cara, hurry, go on.
Then my shout out goes to Werner and Willem Reed Bronkhorst.
That's Werner and Willem. That's awesome. I love it.
Werner and Willem.
Thank you guys so much for being a part of
Thank
the family.
Thank you for being a part of the Chat Fam.
Chat Fam. We love you guys. You're awesome.
Oh, I love that picture.
I know it. They're so cute.
You look happy. Awesome. Love it. Really do. So you guys, thank you so much for being a part of the family, joining us. We're gonna go and put this girl to bed because she is tired.
And then I'm gonna...
What are you gonna do?
Work. I have to do some work.
And
And then maybe get in the hot tub. Do I go in the hot tub?
Yeah, let's do that. Sure. I'm gonna clean this kitchen. Love you guys. We'll see you in 2 days. Toodaloo now.